cost that much, cause I don't have superpowers. You need to pay for my skills, cause exposure doesn't pay the bills. It costs that much, cause it takes me fucking hours. I know you think my prices are negotiable, but if you keep on questioning, I will not be so sociable. And feel free to walk away, cause I know just what my art is worth. So hear me when I say that it costs that much, cause it took me years to master.
Years to master.
You're free to try if you think you'd do it faster.
Do it faster.
But it would likely turn out shit, cause you simply haven't practiced it. It costs that much, cause it took me years to master. Since the dawn of art, there have been people just like you who stand along the sidelines judging everything we do. And I know that you won't be the last, but for every one of you that are class, and it costs that much, cause it takes me fucking hours.
Fucking hours.
It costs that much, cause I don't have superpowers.
Superpowers.
So you need to pay for my skills, cause exposure doesn't pay the bills. It costs that much, cause it takes me fucking hours.
Heyo! How's everybody doing today? Welcome to stream. That was a little intense of a way to start the stream, I think. Jesus Christ. Hold on. Especially for what is supposed to be a chill art stream. I'm still getting set up here too, so. Apologies. I forgot to set my board up. Got people's phones going off. All kinds of stuff going on. Alright. There's that. There's this. Booyah. Okay. Cool. I had a reference image here somewhere. There we go. We're not going to be doing Marvel today. Okay, sorry. Alright, hope everybody's doing well today. It's Sunday. Sunday fun day. Sunday fun stream day. Right, so we're just gonna relax, calm down. I woke up like 15 minutes ago, something like that. Maybe 20. Got a lot of sound effects going on off camera. Alright, cool. Let's get started here. Let's try this nice sketching pen here. That won't work. Alright, so. Welcome everyone. If you're new here, I hope that you will enjoy your stay. So we're doing a portrait today. So we're just gonna sketch it out. Thank you. there. Got our net right here. Like that, roughly.
You are still in my mind.
There's a shoulder there.
The truth is so hard to find. With all the things that's going on, I lost track. I felt so strong.
That's roughly the outline of our subject here. Right. And then we can just go ahead and create a few more layers here. Let's go ahead and name this one real quick. Mother. Fucker. Classic mistake. Classic screw up there. Vert. Mask. Okay. And then we'll go. Smart fast drives. There we go. Now we got a sketch on a separate layer. That's how you fix that very quickly. All right, cool. So in between these two layers, we're going to make a folder. We're going to call this head. Head. Another folder we'll call body. Alright, within head, I'm gonna make just a whole bunch of layers here. We'll call this one base, and that's where we'll start. Alright, need a nice, skin tone here. Let's test this one out here. Yeah, good enough. Alright, let's go ahead and make another layer here. We'll call this palette. Base. And I'm just going to fill in pretty much where my sketch says that the head will be. Make a nice base color for the rest of the colors to sit on top of. This is how I do traditional painting too, whenever I actually do traditional painting. I try to get a nice thick layer of background paint on to make sure that a nice thick layer on in order to make sure that the rest of the paint sits on top of it and you're not seeing any of the canvas through it.
this wrong. Give in to all temptation, you know.
And we got the white in the middle here, but that is actually from the sketch layer. So once we get rid of that, you won't see it anymore. Alright, let's go back to palette. Let's pick a nice. We go there. Yeah, that's right. And that will be the base for the body. Of course, it's not gonna stay this color, like, this will still be there, but it'll be, like, the background, like, any spots where the brush that I'm using doesn't fully cover, there'll at least be something showing through, instead of just the white background. Now, if I get rid of the sketch, yeah, see? We got a little bit right here that we need to just kind of touch up. Go back to the head base layer. I'll just add a little bit more to that on the side there. And since it's underneath of the body layer, it'll work quite nicely. Alright, cool. So let's add on top of the head. Gotta find the right brush. There we go. A little bit lighter of a color here. I'm just gonna try to add in. Skin tone.
That's the mistake that I make probably more than anything else, is being on the wrong layer. Is that as much undo as I can do? Yeah, of course it is. See if I can try to fix this. I think that's good. Make sure that I'm on the correct layer here. Skin tone. Let's also go ahead and thought I clicked on the palette layer, but I guess I didn't. Skin tone. Try this again. Round two. Okay. Might even increase my brush size a bit there. Alright, so. I guess that, change my color back to the color that I had before. There we go. Eventually I'm gonna start working on the skin. I promise. Alright. I'm just brushing away and it's not doing nothing. So we got a little bit on my neck there. We got some here. Basically, I'm going to be covering up all of the skin with this, but I want to get the correct direction of the like how the paint's going to go. So you can kind of see a face developing in there, if that makes sense. I hope so. Alright, so that's the skin tone, I guess. Alright, cool. Now, the highlights will be probably right here. Let's go ahead and put them on our palette. Right, and then the shades should be right about in there. Yeah, that looks good.
Alright, so let's start with Shadow, since we've already got that one selected. A very strong Shadow right here. Alright, it's the Shadow under the ear. Comes to the edge of the jaw and then back. And then right along the edge of the neck. I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Bring it around. Some shadow up the edge of the face, where the face and the neck connect there. A lot of this isn't going to matter because I'm going to be maybe changing this to black and white when I'm done, which I don't normally do. Normally if I'm going to do something in black and white, I just do it in black and white. But I hit P instead of, yeah, my shortcuts were a little messed up. Alright, so I'm kind of bring this shadow down. This is a shadow from the chin. Slightly bigger brush, and then I'm just gonna do this whole thing. Light dusting of shadow. Light dusting. Alright, cool. There's actually a little bit of highlight right there, so. Alright. A light dusting of shadow right here. Brush down. This can come right up. Just like that. And then we got a little bit of shadow on this side. A little bit on the brow. Over here. Okay, so I'm gonna start getting a little bit of the detail in here. This brow is actually a little bit lower here, so I'll go ahead and erase that. I can put it in. Okay. There we go. There's the side of the face there. We got over here. We'll be right back. cool. So it's coming along quite nicely, actually. I know that if you're watching this, it doesn't look like it. Probably looks like, what the hell is this guy doing? But I can see the face that I'm doing shaping up. So that is a plus. It's a little bit right there. And then this actually gets really dark right here. Pretty normal for an illustration to not really look like what it's supposed to be at first. But you'll see it slowly start to shape. So we got the ear going on there. Alright. Now, let's see. The ear and the nose are pretty much done as far as highlights go. The mouth is pretty much done. Like, as far as the shading goes with the skin. Eyes. Yeah, I do want to erase a little bit around this eye here. A little too far up. There we go. Now. I'm gonna leave it for now. Okay. Let's go ahead and switch over to the highlight. And we'll get some of the highlights on here. We'll start with the chinny chin chin. Mother,
She always wants to call while I'm streaming, it seems. I don't think she really gets the live streaming thing. So I'll say, hey, I'm streaming right now. She'll be like, oh, okay. You got a minute? I want to have a conversation. And it's like, ah, man, I don't. But what do you want? You know? Love her to death, but she's a lot to deal with sometimes. She means well, I think. A little bit. Oh yeah. See that? The eyes are off center. This eye should be like way up here, I think. So let's go ahead and just that. I'll have to go and fix the shading here. Paint bucket, silly. Just want to get rid of this really dark spot right here. Okay. And then I can put it back in where it needs to go, which is way up here. Better. Let's go back to the highlight. Let's go to the eraser, and I'm actually going to switch to the graphite new eraser and just kind of bring this down just a hair. It's a bit much there. So these little spots here are the bottom eyelids. Oh man. Alright. So we should see a face really coming together here. I'll give it about another 25 minutes, and then I'm gonna take a break and I'll call my mom. See what's going on. She's probably wanting to tell me not to call this number that she had given me. She like called me and she's like, yeah, Jim, which is her husband, his aunt filled out this application for a grant for $30,000. Here's the number and you can get it. It's for disabled and elderly and people going to school and people trying to start their own business and this and that. It's pretty much anybody will qualify. I'm like, Mom, that sounds like a scam. So obviously I didn't call the number, but she texted me the next day. Do not call that number. Is scam. Like, yeah, Mom, I know. She's a character. All right. Let's go eyes. Eyes are going to be easy because the person is squinting. And it's actually going to be a really, really dark color here. Let's go ahead and just add the color to the palette. Alright, and then back to graphite new. And back to the eyes layer. And I'm going to go ahead and clip this level, this layer as well. Bring my brush down.
know these don't look like eyes. Yet. Gonna take a much lighter color here. Just do that. Even though you can't really tell in the photo, I know that the white, there's like some white eye right there. But we'll see once it gets a little bit closer to that. You know, let me see how this looks in black and white, though. I am curious, and also I want to try to remember how the hell to do that. So I think it's adjustments, black and white. Is that it? No. Okay. Well. Is it mode grayscale? That might be it. You know, we're gonna cancel. We'll do that later. Because it's gonna mess things up, I feel. Alright, cool. So, eyes are done. For now. Let's go ahead and get some... I think maybe some mouth... some mouth going here, so... we're gonna go mouth, face, and I don't really need to clip it. Alright. So there's a nice starter mouth, I guess. Clip a couple layers on here. Probably just the two there. Some detail in here. Alright, so let's change this one to shadow, go back to highlight. All right, and then I want a nice light. light tone here, and it's not going to be much. A little bit here. And really, that's it. A little bit there. All right, so
save me now, hold on. I don't want to fight this war for something, don't want to fight this war for nothing.
And nobody's teeth are like exactly white, right? So it's, I don't anyway, put it all the way as white as it will go, pretty much any, ever, or all the way as black as it will go, pretty much ever, because every color that you paint is going to be in between black and white, in my experience. Alright, so, teeth, once it's home. And we'll bring that down, and I'm just going to erase where the gum line is. If that makes sense.
Save us all, fall down. Save us from the things that tend to hurt us. All the whispers that will haunt ya. Climb out of the hell we made. I gotta get out, gotta get out, gotta get out. I don't wanna be alone. Soon let's just say that we fit perfectly in harmony. And I worry, oh, it's you and me, a recipe. For eternity, but we broke, and it's too late to say I'm sorry for the red light that stopped me.
All right, here's the one spot that we'll use the white. You typically want to, if you use the black or the white, you only want to use it in one spot in your entire thing. It's going to be right here with the light reflecting off the teeth. Gum line. That seems to be the whitest spot there. The darkest spot always seems to be like right here. Like the crook of the elbow at certain angles, or right here. But yeah, that's neither here nor there right now. I think the darkest spot on this one is probably going to be right here. Alright. Let's get some eyebrows on this fool. Hey, we've actually used every single layer so far in our head folder. So we'll go ahead and make some more. I think three more layers for now. Eyebrows. And eyebrows I'm gonna bring down here, clip. All right, and then I kind of doing the bottoms of the eyebrows real quick. A bit more detail to the eyebrow as we go, but for now, just want to kind of get a nice idea of where they're going to be. Brushes than this one. Ah. Probably go with this. Stubble. Since it's an eyebrow. Bring this down. Let's go back to the eyes layer real quick. I'm going to kind of blend these out because they're fucking creeping me out. Tough. There's some tough eyes. I don't know if you can tell who this is yet or not, but it's not the best illustration, I don't think. I think that there's a few things that need to be changed. Starters, mouth, up some. Mouth was a little bit smaller than it needed to be. The teeth.
teeth themselves. Let me zoom in. Kind of looking back and forth between what I've got and the photo. Okay. Face. Alright, we'll start working on the hair now. As soon as I find my hair. Brush down. Alright, so got sideburn. I'm on my eraser. That's what the issue is. Alright, we got a sideburn. Goes over top of the head, and then we'll get a layer in the background that will go under the head.
When the downtown lights start to come out at night, we go insane, we go insane. And when I arrive, I start to lose my mind. I go insane, I go insane. Cause they told me you take too much. Yeah, I sure do, so I can feel that now. If they only knew how this was. Yeah, they would too, just to feel that now. Cause I ain't got no friends, I ain't got nobody. All I got ahead is a moonlit road.
Make a hair guideline there.
When
the downtown lights start to come out at night, we go insane, we go insane. And when I arrive, I start to
get rid of these guides.
Go insane.
Not screwing too much up.
Insane. Cause they told me you take too much. Yeah, I sure do, so I can feel that now. If they only knew how this was, yeah, they would too, just to feel that now.
Touch up the hairline, just a hair. Ah. Alright, so there's that. The tops of the hair here don't really matter right now because I'm going back through. There's gonna be hair behind it. Just wanna make sure that it's covering up the scalp for the most part. She does have really thick hair. Alright. And then I'm just gonna, on this back layer, it's actually gonna go. Hair back. It's gonna come all the way down here. Right. And then. This technique with putting the hair on a back layer and a front layer usually works fairly well for the hair like this, because you won't, you think about it, people's hair is over top of their scalp, right? It's also on the back of their head, right? So you want be able to show that. Take a little bit darker, right? And then just gonna get that darker color over top of it. Down here, we'll have a couple of little spots here and there. Just have the darker hair in it. Here has it.
kind of some spots in here, just like randomly. Still bothering me though. I feel like the mouth is just bigger is what the problem is. Do that, and we will just come in here to the bass. Just erase a little bit here. Teeth are bothering me too. We'll fix the teeth after break though. So I'm gonna go ahead and take about probably 5 to 8 minute break. So yeah, enjoy this music, I guess, and I'll see you when I get back.
I was muted that whole time. Hey, I'm back. That was eventful. That was an eventful break. One of the things that I did during break, though, is took a step back and looked at what I've been working on. And honestly, it doesn't look that good. I'm going to try to fix it. I know that the entire head needs to turn. It should be at an angle. So I'm going to select all of those layers all the way down to there, and I'm just going to tilt like that, and then we'll move like that. Roughly there. All right, and then let's take the body layer and actually move it down here so it's behind the head. That. Go back to total brush. All
tones to it that I'm noticing, but they are kind of in the background, so I wanted to get them in there, and then I'll just go back over top with a darker color so that, darker than that actually, so that it, they're there and they're shining through. So that actually looks quite a bit better already. Obviously, I still need to fix this here, but I think that this is a little bit less pompadour and a little more just like wild, curly. I think that that looks a bit better here. Alright. I think we're gonna leave the head right now, and we'll go into doing the body a bit. So that was quite a bit to have to deal with. trying to fix. So, alright. Let's go ahead down to the them boys, and then click on shade. All right, cool. So, that. Take a nice coat of the dark here. There we go. And then we'll go to highlight. That's a good color for it, but that was a little more than I needed right there. Alright, right there. Maybe like that. A little bit on the edge of the collar here. And then... what the hell key did I even just hit? I don't even know. Alright. I'm zooming in so that I can see what the hell I'm doing here. Go with this right here. This would be shirt. Good. Thank you.
Okay. And then tie. Let's go with a
lighter dark blue, if that makes sense. Teal highlights in here. Here and there, just for a splash of extra color. Stitch the palette. Background wall. Oops. Wrong layer. It's that one. Yeah, a little bit lighter than that. Yeah, right there. Alright. Now, let's get rid of the sketch. Those teeth need to be fixed. I can't even. There's the teeth. Okay. Teeth are too... Well, for one, they're too pronounced. Toots. There's too much going on with these teeth. Trying too hard to like put the detail in there, I think. I'm just gonna kinda go over top of it, right? Just give it the idea of space, idea of gums, I think is a little bit better than actually like trying to make a gum line and bottoms of the teeth, so. Yeah, because now there's way too many damn teeth in his mouth. Alright, so. Alright. Let's go ahead and take it back to grayscale again. Merge, discard. We'll do the signature again. Alright, so, if you weren't aware of who this is, it's Norm MacDonald. Back when he was much younger on Weekend Update. On SNL. So, I hope that it came across good. Kind of a tribute piece. A lot of people didn't like Norm MacDonald. They didn't think he was funny. They didn't really get his dry sense of humor. And they were wrong. I've thought Norm MacDonald was hilarious like since the first time I saw him. His homosexuality and sexism, it was all fake, or it's fake as it can be for Norm MacDonald, I guess. He could always tell when he was joking because he had that little like shit-eating grin on his face, like, yeah, this is gonna piss you off and I don't care because it's a joke. And I always appreciated that. He was just genuinely a funny dude. Took a lot of backlash for his O.J. Simpson jokes on SNL, which is why he lost his job there. And then, like, what, a year later, they called him back to host. Which is just hilarious if you think about it. And I take a lot of inspiration from Norm with my own comedy. Just the dry, deadpan, like, I'll say something very deadpan and look directly at the person, but I'll have a little bit of a smirk on my face. Mine isn't as noticeable as Norm's, I think maybe because of the beard. But my girlfriend gets on me all the time because I tease her too much. And she doesn't know whether I'm joking or not. And, I think that she, deep down in her soul, she knows that I'm joking. But, yeah. Norm MacDonald, ladies and gentlemen. Norm MacDonald. So, I hope that you enjoyed this little art stream that we did here. Let me cut this music. And we will minimize my image there. Minimize that. I got a lot going on my screen here. Okay, so, yeah, I hope that you enjoyed this little art stream. I was going to do a Marvel character, and I went and I found a model picture, and I was going through different Marvel characters to do, and I thought, you know what, I want to do a Norm MacDonald tribute piece, because he really was one of the greats, and His passing saddens me. So yeah, that's all I'm going to say on it, because I don't want to upset myself, but we'll go ahead and we will get ready to end stream here. I'm going to go ahead and play this song while we go. I love this song, and so we'll listen to this while we look for someone to raid, and see who's doing art other than Bob Ross. Anybody?
I know you think my prices are negotiable, but if you keep on questioning, I will not be so sociable, and feel free to walk away.
I don't know what this person is. Arting. So hear me when I say I gotta wait for the commercial to end.
You're free to try if you think you do it faster.
Can't tell what they're arting. Oh, it looks like they're doing some concept art. So cool. So we'll go ahead and we will raid.
Since the dawn of art,
give him a follow real quick.
People just like you who stand along the sidelines judging everything we do, and I know that you won't be the last.
Alright, and if you're interested in donating to charity, check the about section down below. And we're still raising money for St. Jude's. I didn't pick a new charity this month, I know. But yeah, we'll go ahead and we will raid Dextralicious. And go check out his content. If you like it, give him a follow. And we'll see you in the next stream. So, I guess, take care. See you next time. Should be streaming some Final Fantasy Friday. Might do a little impromptu stream sometime between now and then. We'll see. So, yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Later.